Good morning. Today we'll discuss about data mining applications. Data mining having vast applications, most of the in domain data mining concepts were used. So data mining is a young discipline with broad and diverse applications. There still exists a non-trivial gap between generic data mining methods and effective and scalable data mining tools for domain specific applications. So some of the domain applications were listed over here. They are all data mining for financial data analysis, then retail and telecommunication industries, then science and engineering, then intrusion detection and prevention, then finally recommender systems. So first we'll see financial data analysis. Data mining for financial data analysis. Financial data collected in banks and financial institutions are often relatively complete and reliable and of high quality. Why? Because there they are using a systematic procedure to maintain the bank transactions or finance related transactions. So they will have reliable and high quality data. And design and construction of data warehouses. For multi-dimensional data analysis and data mining. So data warehouses can be designed and constructed for multi-data analysis and data mining. By designing and constructing data warehouses for multi-dimensional data analysis, we'll be able to view the debit and revenue changes by month and by region, by sector and by factors. So we'll be able to view the debit details, revenue changes, monthly, region wise, sector wise or other factors. So with the help of this multi-dimensional data analysis, it will assess the statistical information such as maximum, minimum, total and average trend, etc. Here if you go for loan payment, so by using data mining concept, we'll be able to predict the loan payment. Who are all eligible for availing loan amount and how, what about their credit policies. So they will be able to do everything with the help of the data mining concept. And here we are using data mining concept for feature selection and attribute relevance rankings. And same way we are using data mining concept for payment performance also, loan payment performance also, how they are doing loan payment or loan repayment also. And consumer credit rating, suppose when the customer trying to avail a home loan or any other loan, what about their credit rating? So based on the credit rating, so they will be eligible for high loan. And the next one is data mining for financial data analysis continuations. Here the classification and clustering of a customers for targeted marketing we are using. So classification and clustering are all data mining concept. These techniques are used to find or identify the targeted customers for marketing. Here we are using multi-dimensional segmentation by nearest neighbor classifications, decision tree. They are all data mining concept, etc. to identify customer groups. Okay, and associate a new customer to an appropriate customer group. So we will be able to identify what customer group, as well as we will try to add new customer with existing customers. Next, detection of money laundering and other financial crimes. So what are the money laundering and other financial crimes that will be detected with the help of this data mining concept? Here the integration of from multiple database. Here each and every bank have some database. All the database will be integrated by that. By sitting in a single place, you will be able to track all your transactions or federal state crime history, etc. And here we have a number of tools like data visualization tools, linkage analysis, classification, clustering tools, outlier analysis and sequential pattern analysis tools. So like that, you will have more and more data mining tools. By using the tool, we will be able to do a different process like we will be able to visualize the data in different manners, and we'll be analyze linking analysis. Suppose we have a multiple database, how the databases are linked. When we have multiple data, how the data were linked. So we have multiple files, so how the files were linked, how the and same way we'll be able to classify or cluster, or we can do some outlier analysis also. Next one is data mining for retail and telecommunication industries. So here the retail industries, it's one of the very biggest what application for data mining. Here a huge amount of data on sales, customer, shopping, shopping history and e-commerce, etc. So everywhere we are applying this data mining concept. See, for example, this data mining concept, when you apply in retail industries, there it will help you to identify customer buying behaviors. So there are different types of different levels of buying behavior our customers. So we need to understand their behavior, buying behavior of the behavior. By that we'll be able to keep our update our store with new products. Okay, and moreover, it help you to discover customer shopping patterns and trends. See, there are some products which will be available always in the shop, and there are some products will be there in the trend. So customer coming to shop the product, so what is their shopping pattern? First, what they will purchase. Second, what they will do. Second, third, I mean, so one by one, how the product can be purchased. So what are the sequence of the purchase, product purchase. So those things will be discovered with the help of this data mining concept. And moreover, the trend, based on that, the trend will be analyzed. And another one is improve the quality of the customer survey. Suppose when you go and purchase, as a customer, if you go and purchase a product in a supermarket, so for you, they will try to identify the services. So suppose if you came by car, so the things will be loaded in your car with the help of by providing some assistance. Same way, you will be given vegetable trolley. So by using trolley, you will be able to purchase your product conveniently. So like that, and same way they will give some door delivery also, or they will in person they will ask you what do you want. So like that, their kind of services will be provided. These services will be identified with the help of the data mining concept and achieve better customer retention and satisfaction. So by using this data mining concept, by doing customer service, we'll be able to maintain, or we'll be able to have a very good customer retention as well as satisfaction. And of course, we'll be able to enhance the good goods consumption ratios and design more effective goods transportations and distribution. As I told you, they'll be able to deliver product in door deliveries, and they will provide a separate vehicle to carry their goods. So like that, there will be more transportations will be provided to the customer. These things will be analyzed with help of the data mining concept. Our next one is the telecom, and many other industries share many similar goals expectations like retail data mining. Okay, and here next one is the data mining practice for retail industries. So this continuation here, the design and construction of data warehouses. So data warehouses will be designed and constructed for multidimensional data analysis. Here specifically it is for sales, product sales and customer satisfactions, a customer identification, customer behavior analysis or product analysis, time and region with respect to time. Analysis of the effectiveness of the sales campaigns will be done, and customer retentions will be done always with the help of data mining, like analysis of customer loyalty. These customer loyalty card informations to register sequence, by providing some customer loyalty card, they'll be able to collect the customer informations and their behavior. So based on their behavior and that capacity, they'll be able to give some offer. And use a sequential pattern mining to investigate the changes in customer consumptions or loyalty, and suggest adjustments on the pricing and variety of goods according to the customer. for customer loyalty. They will do some adjustment in the pricing as well as and variety of goods. So they will try to provide variety of goods according to the desires of customer. And product recommendations and cross references of items. Okay, it will be done by data mining. And fraudulent analysis and the identification of usual pattern. Suppose if you done a very good analysis of the pattern, customer pattern, so you will be able to identify fraudulent if you have any changes in the pattern. And use of visualization tool in data analysis. So you need to have visualization tool. By that you can have some kind of data analysis like monthly, weekly, or yearly or day by day. You can see the product sales and customer behaviors or some manpower requirements. Other things will be able to do it visually. So data warehouse and data processing in science and engineering. There it will help you to resolve inconsistencies or incompatible data collected in the diverse environments and the different periods like ecosystem studies. Here mining complex data types, for example, if you take a spatiotemporal, that means what, space related data with the time, time related data, and biological data, diverse semantics and relationship data. So these type of complex data can be analyzed with the help of the data mining. And graph based and network based. And suppose when you have a network, there you have number of nodes, so number of links, okay, number of databases. So everything will be analyzed based on the links, relationship, data flow, etc. The help of the data mining. And here also we have visualization tool and domain specific knowledges. Okay, there we have some other issues also, like in data mining in social science and social studies. There you will have, you may have text also, text type of data as well as social media data. So you will be able to understand or identify that data type, as well as we have to do the data mining process. And data mining in computer science, here by using computer in computer, by using data mining concept, we will try to do some monitoring systems. And of course we can find some software bugs in the software by with the help of data mining. Of course you can also do network intrusion. And the next one is the data mining for intrusion detections and the preventions. So here most of the intrusion detections will be the intrusion will be based on the signature. So signature based detections will be done in data mining. Here use signature attack patterns that are pre-configured and pre-determined by the domain expert. There will be number of domain experts. They have very high experience, so they know what are the different types of attack in pattern wise or signature wise. Okay, so those things will be pre-configured by using data mining. And anomaly based detections, here build a profile and detect those that are substantially deviate from the profile. Okay, so here we first of all we need to build a profile, and by that we'll be able to detect the anomalies. And what data mining can help? So data mining can help for new data mining algorithm for intrusion detections. And here by using data mining algorithm like association, correlations and discriminative pattern analysis to help select and build discriminative classifiers. Okay. And data mining help to analyze of stream data, like you can take data mining concept like outlier detections. This is a data mining concept. And clustering data mining concept or model shifting data mining concept. These data mining concept can be used for analysis of stream data like video stream, audio stream. Okay, so like that you can use it. And next one is distributed data mining. So here data can be distributed everywhere. So which data can be available where and what type of data, how it is distributed, so where are the nodes are there. So all those things will be collected with the help of data mining. Of course, we have here also visualizations as well as querying tools. So by using visualization tools, I will be able to visualize all kind of data in different manners, as well as by giving queries, you will be able to collect the data from the database. And there will be a recommender systems. So by recommender system, we will be able to recommend some of the things, like you can personalize your networks. So you being a customer, you will be able to search some of the topics that can be based on your content. So that can be recommended, web page can be recommended for you always. There is a content based and collaborative filtering you have. And data mining recommender system, there are different